back to Nautanki. Mom, I'm Divya and a very warm namaste to all of you. Yes, we are in India and after a long time we are back in our home country. Feels great. It's winters here, so we've been enjoying the weather and actually I've been away from camera for the last 1 month and just been soaking up the sun and having some really good family time. We recently traveled from Singapore to India and I thought why not share this experience with many out there who might be planning a similar trip and maybe having a lot of queries and questions in their mind. I thought it'll be a good thing to share my experience of my travel from Singapore to India, especially during the COVID times. Last year, November end is when we were planning to travel to India and we were also very anxious. We had a lot of questions in our mind and that's why after doing the travel and taking the flight and everything, I thought it'll be a good, useful information to pass it on to fellow friends who might be keen to travel and this may help them in planning their travel to India. Let's get started. So in today's video, I'll be telling you about my flight details, the flight experience, some tips if you're traveling with your kids, and the overall experience of traveling from Singapore to India. As some of you may know that right now there's only one flight which is flying from Singapore to India, which is Vande Bharat flight. So you don't have much choice in that. You just select the date on which you want to fly. I guess even the rates are same even if you do in advance booking or closer to the date of travel, the rate remains the same. So I remember in early December we were planning to book the tickets for January and the tickets were still available till about mid of December. So that was our experience. You can still check on the website and check for the availability of the tickets. The flight is right now flying only on Wednesdays and Saturdays. The time is standard for us. The flight was at 9:35 a.m. in the morning. So the Vande Bharat flight, which is going from Singapore to India, is actually not direct to Delhi since I was coming to Delhi. So you go via Bangalore. So from Singapore, you go to Bangalore and then from Bangalore, you go to Delhi. So if you talk about the distance, the time, I think from Singapore to Bangalore it takes about 3.5 hours, and from Bangalore to Delhi it's about 1.5 hours of flight. The flight ticket was about $400 per person, Singapore dollars, and so you can take that down, it might help you in your budgeting. Now since I told you that the flight was at 9:35 a.m. so we were supposed to reach the airport, Singapore airport, Changi airport, 3 hours in advance, so make sure that you have buffer time. Especially if you're traveling with kids and toddlers. I have a 6-year-old daughter and a 10-month-old son, so I had to really make sure that I have enough time to manage everything. Also, please make a note of it that once you are at the airport, there are a lot of forms that needs to be filled, so it's better that you reach there before time. And I suggest it's always good to carry your own pen, so carry that, it's handy. If you have an infant like I do, I suggest it's always good to keep your stroller handy, and I also kept a baby carrier just in case sometimes babies don't feel like they don't sit in the stroller for a long time or they get cranky, so it's always good to hold them, and since the airports are so big and you have to walk for so long, so it's good to keep the baby carrier as well as the stroller both handy, and they can go in your cabin luggage. My experience of Changi airport was actually the airport unlike when situation was normal, there was no COVID. Changi airport was always buzzing, but when we went, it was about early January. The airport was not that crowded, which was good, but the flights were full. People are traveling very much from Singapore to India, and I know there are people like myself, because even we were very confused whether we should travel or not, keeping in because of the whole COVID situation, and we've been contemplating about the travel for a very long time. But then finally we took the plunge. We thought, no, we have to go. We've been wanting to be with our families, and I can relate to the emotions of many out there who might be wanting to come to India, but may be holding back due to the situation, but I suggest it's not that bad. Definitely you can plan and travel and be with your family. So overall the flight was good from Singapore. Everything was on time, and we reached Bangalore in about the afternoon time, and from Bangalore further 1.5 hours to Delhi. Food was okay. Generally I'm not very fond of flight food, so I would rather suggest you to carry some stuff, especially if you're with kids, with handy foods would be good for the infants. Dry food items you can keep, like biscuits. Of course you can't carry liquids, so you can only, what you can stock up is the dry food items. Of course at Changi Airport the measures were very much in place, whether it was social distancing or from point to point there were sanitizers. The place was being maintained and kept very clean to make sure that the travel is done, is undertaken safely by the travelers. In the flights we were given the kits, so the kit which was given had sanitizer, wipes, mask and face shield. Okay, once you are in Bangalore, once you reach Bangalore from Singapore, there's a halt of 45 minutes, and in that you have to stay in the flight itself. You don't have to get down, you don't have to deboard. That is something which I also wanted to know when I was planning to travel. So for 45 minutes you are in the flight, and then again it takes off for Delhi. We reached India at around 3:30 p.m. Afternoon time. Of course Singapore is 2.5 hours ahead of India, so yeah, it was afternoon time here. I always feel when you are in flight, prefer having yogurt if it is being served. It's always, it goes easy on your tummy and keeps it fine, rather than having fried food which may cause some acidity. So I think most of the flight foods, they have a yogurt or a curd item, so make sure you consume that. It goes easy on your tummy and you don't feel very heavy and stuffy after having your meal. Now just few tips if you are traveling with your baby. My baby, as I told you, is 10 months old. When I was traveling he was about 9. So while it's very strange, because most of the people were telling me, I was traveling with my son for the first time, so they said that whenever the flight takes off or lands you feed the baby, but actually the cabin crew members told me not to do that because the baby might choke. I'm just sharing this with you because it might help you, don't actually feed the baby when the flight is landing or taking off. They actually say to just hold the baby upright, in the upright position, and that's it, and just hold him closer to you. No feeding, nothing whatsoever. I also kept a soother just in case, just a nipple soother in case he gets very cranky. Though he was not used to it, but still it just engaged him for some time, so you can consider keeping something like that. Also another thing which I found very useful is that you can keep a string, like any string, and you can tie his favorite toys or any of the things which he's very fond of, small items, and you can tie it with his hand or with his dress or something, just pin it up or something like that, so that it doesn't fall. My major worry was how to keep my baby in one place because of the whole coronavirus situation and the, you know, virus being, could be at any place, anywhere. So of course as parents we were concerned. This thing helped us to just keep his hands to himself, because most of the times his hand is either in his mouth or he's touching everywhere. So if you keep some things tied to him, he's just engaged with that. Similarly the soother was something new for him, so he was engaged with that as well for some time. And yeah, if you have two kids then it always helps. You can take the help of the elder one to keep the younger one busy. Of course it's always good to have all your papers and documents and everything in one bag. So especially when you reach the airport and you are doing your forms and you're filling up everything, it's always good to have one file in which you have all the documents. So make sure you have one file which is like, which can carry a good amount of papers, because these documents and your forms can be a wholesome amount of papers. So yeah, carry a file with you, it may come handy. So this is it. I have made a video after a very long time, and I hope that I continue making such videos for you which can help you, which can give you important information, which can come handy. And yeah, this is it. Do let me know if you have any questions in the comment section. I will see you next week with another video. Till then, peace.